way, Aishan and Gemma, loving the messages coming through about Donald's song. Anonymous, why don't you want to tell me your name? So thank you for Donald's song, lovely. Now, Aishan, you guys are rocking my Friday, which is what we do, Espestandismo, right here on ZiFM Stereo. Remember, you can also listen to us on the line, as my Rosie is doing. My Rosie's listening to me all the while in the UK. That's zfmstereo.co.zw. Now, how much do you know about Zimbabwe as a country? As an adult, even. Now imagine if you're 8 years old and you wrote a whole book. That's who we're going to be talking to right now.
Amard in the afternoon on scene.
It's Amard.
Amard.
Clap your hands. It's Amard on the Big Show.
Weekdays.
12 to 3.
So yes, I asked you, how much do you actually know about this beautiful country called Zimbabwe? If you don't know much, well, someone is here to help you. Her name is Waka, and she's 8 years old and has written a whole book. Waka, my darling, how are you?
I'm good, thanks.
Look, what made you want to write a book? You're 8 years old. You should be playing in the soil or something. Why do you want to write a book? Why? You tell me, what inspired you?
It was the places that I've been in Zim, like Nyanga, Kariba, and all those other awesome places.
And with all of that, because I've been to Nyanga and Kariba, and I think those places are super, super beautiful. What made you want to sit down and say, you know, I need to tell my friends, I need to tell the whole country about how beautiful Nyanga and Kariba and the rest of Zimbabwe is? What did you see?
Well, it was just an essay, because my mom tells me to write essays a lot. So this essay was about the places I've been in Zim. So it just ended up being a book, and I don't know how.
You don't know how it became a book?
It was just an idea, like an essay, and then my mom decided to turn it into a book, which was really cool, so I agreed, and then I didn't know it was going to be on, like, shops and all, but, well, here I am.
Look, that is so beautiful. So, obviously, you're really good at creative writing. You've been sitting down and writing a lot in school. What school do you go to?
I go to Chisipite Junior School.
Nice, and what grade are you in?
Grade 3.
Wait, what? You're in grade 3?
Yep.
And you've written a book.
Yes.
Okay, we need to know, who is your teacher? What's your teacher's name?
Bridget Riley. She's my teacher.
You call your teacher by her name?
No. We call her Mrs. Riley, but her first name is Bridget.
Nice, nice. I was so shocked. I don't even know most of my teacher's first names, and you know that one. Okay. So I want you, it's going to be a crazy question, but I need to answer you to answer me as honestly as you possibly can. Which is your favorite place in Zim?
Nyanga. Chobbek and Nyanga. That is my absolute favorite place.
I love that place too. Confirm, it just feels like there's so much air and it's just so much cleaner and it's just so beautiful. Mm. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Right. We're going to keep on talking. We're going to keep on talking in a little bit. But for now, we're going to take a little musical break. I want to know from you, which is your favorite song?
My favorite song?
Yeah.
I would say...
Oh. Oh, you don't have one?
I do.
Because you know I'm going to play Baby Shark if you don't.
It's a new song from a new movie called Bounce the Beat Off My Own Drum from Vivo.
From Vivo? Yeah, no, I don't have that one. I was going to play it for you and seem cool, but I don't have that one. You have to give me another one.
Okay, well, probably one of the Frozen 2 songs.
Okay, I feel like we're on a totally different level right now. I will not play Baby Shark because that's so not cool. What if I play you some... 24K.
Sure.
All right.
Okay.
But do not cut the phone, okay? We need to have a conversation with your mom to find out exactly how this all went down. So don't touch that dial, all right?
Okay.
I told you I'm in the studio. How many times you gonna call me?
Damn.
Sure.
Let it fart, I don't need no brakes.
Go, go. It's a nail. You ain't really bad, I can tell.
I'm loving how incredulous everyone is. Auntie, how is an eight-year-old writing a book? Like, yes, I don't, maybe we have to ask her mom, Sharon.
Hi, Amard.
How did you push from an essay to a book?
So I have a writing essays every weekend, just for two things. One, helping with the vocabulary, the spellings, the creativity, the penmanship, because she's only 8, so they to practice that handwriting, and the typing skills, because I also ask her to type it sometimes or to write it. So sometimes she comes up with these very interesting essays, and I circulate them to like grandparents and family. And when I circulated this particular one, everyone was like, this is so fantastic. She should write a book. And that's really how it started. It was one of her grandmothers is Barbara Makalisankala, who is an author. And she was like, Mokoti, I think you should really think about making this into a book, even if it's for just us family. And that's how it started. And then before we knew it, it's now on Amazon. It's in bookshops.
Wow.
And it's all over, yeah.
Look, talk about saving up for university fees.
That's what she claims. She says it's for MIT tuition fees. So I'm all set.
Okay, MIT, right? I love how everyone is still incredulous about that. Auntie, I wish I could write a book and I'm 16. How do I go on about doing that? So, okay, obviously we've explained that. And another message coming through from MK Embardo says, how on earth did she write a book? I'm in Form 3 and I can't even write a book or a song. Wow. Some of this takes time. And we heard that her grandmother's an author, so maybe that did contribute to that. And also just traveling. Like, why was it so important for her to focus on the traveling? Because we always say traveling opens up the mind.
Yeah. It was, so she'd written other essays on other things, and this particular weekend, I said, write about the places you've been to and which one was your favorite. And so she wrote, I think, about Nyanga, which is her absolute favorite. She wrote about Leopard Rock, because we'd just been there for Christmas. And then when people said, turn this into something more, then she added Kariba and Victoria Falls. She added her Kumusha in Wedza. She added her favorite places in Harare as well. So that's how it grew from being an essay to something much more into a book.
Look, I think maybe we need to speak to the author just one last time before we're done with the show. If you do have any questions for Waka, the number is 0731 168 045. Waka, my darling, this is now me just being curious, what would you like to be when you grow up?
I would like to be an optometrist, a hacker, a scientist, so many things, a ballerina.
Wow. Do you know what? And I'll tell you
as well.
You know, I'm going to tell you this. Everyone always says that you can only be one thing in your life, but I'm going to tell you this. You can be every single one of those things if you want, okay?
Okay.
Right. And I want you to tell me, what is your message that you have for other kids who are interested in writing?
I'd say be creative and never give up and read loads of books. It helps with your spellings and your creativity.
Waka, you have been absolutely amazing. I hope Mom is going to let you call for Junior Z. Mom? I'm hearing giggling, yeah, but no one is saying yes. It's fine. It's fine. It's okay. It's okay. You have a gem in your hands, and she's going to be one of our biggest writers. I'm speaking that into existence. Thank you so much for giving us your time for us to have a conversation with Waka about her new book.
Thank you. And she asked me to mention that she's starting a book club on her Facebook page. So she wants more and more kids to be able to write, and so that our kids consume content that they create for themselves that's more relevant. So please check it out.
You know what? That is so important. So you can follow Waka on her Facebook. That is Waka's Book Club. That's Waka's Book Club. Or on YouTube, Waka Tenda Bwanya. Family, thank you so much.
Thank you, Amard. Cheers.
Root Bone August Z. We are-